How many of y'all noticed on that show I had my wife with me the whole time? Only time I didn't have her with me is when I sung that song in Vegas. Because they didn't fly her out. And I had to fly her out like every time I went. And then when we went to Vegas, it's like no audience. You're just in there with the three judges that you just saw in New York and you wowed them. They're sitting there like this. So I almost went home right there. But my wife, she is like a powerful woman, ain't she? She cried me all the way to the number one spot. Every day she was crying like, oh! Commercial break. Oh! Next week's episode. Oh! And all y'all was so nice to her. It's like, oh, your wife is so beautiful. She's so sweet. Do you guys do any songs together? I was like, yeah. Why don't you bring her on the show with you? I was like, nah. But today I have a special treat for you guys. I would like to bring to the stage my lovely wife, Miss Jennifer!
Forevermore,
that's how you'll stay.
That's-
was on that show, after I won, I got my own headlining show at Caesar's Palace, and I sold out every night I was there. Coliseum. At that same time, I got to meet some interesting people, and I had these two background singers that were, like, amazing, and I kept one of them. California, I'd like you to give it up for your own Laura Johnson. Christina Aguilera. She good with all that. She killing it. So I've just been having so much fun, man. I'm living my dreams out every day. Sometimes I wake up and be people throwing rocks at my window like, Landau, come out here and sign my baby. I'm gonna tell y'all something that's really funny. Even if the rest of the states didn't vote for me, West Virginia was not gonna let me lose. They voted all their dead relatives, all their cousins, and it was just so funny because, like, when I came home, I couldn't tell nobody what I did, and I had to just sit and wait for it to air on television. And then when it aired, all these guys were coming up to me like, hey, boy, come here. I gotta tell you something. I was out there in the garage just fixing and tinkering on the truck there. And my wife runs outside screaming to the top of her lungs. She said, Bob, you gotta come in here and listen to this boy. He sounds just like Frank Sinatra. And he said, okay, I'll be in there in a minute, sweetheart. I run in the house, you know, like standing in front of the television set. I said, boy, that ain't Frank Sinatra. That boy's blacker than a spade. I was like, should I hit you in the mouth or should I just hug you? I don't know what to do. You know, but it was just crazy. They was not going to let me lose that contest. whatsoever. And you guys weren't neither. You know, you just did me. God bless me so much. I don't even know how to explain it. But this is what I want you to do.
Let's fly.